Hi, teachers. I wanted to share a really incredible resource that I've just run across that is super easy to add to your Google Chrome browser that you can use for yourself or to show students how to cite resources not in our databases. Most of our databases, if not all of them, have an automatic citation creator built in, which is wonderful and easy to use, but not everything that you can find that you need or that children need is on a database. So I wanted to show you an example of when that would happen and then how you can use this new resource. So this is a Chrome extension, and to find all of the Chrome apps and extensions, if you just search for Google Chrome Store or Chrome Web Store, or you can use this website here. So if you go in here, you can type in the source that I'm talking about is called Cite This For Me, and it's an extension. So if you choose that and type in Cite This For Me, you can pull up all the things that they think might fit what you're looking for. And I've already added it to my browser, but it'll have a little blue button to add to Chrome. If you want to read a little bit about it, you just click on it, tells you what it is. But basically, this extension allows you to go to any website that you are using for information, automatically create a citation that you can then, or the students can then use in their presentations. So we've added it here, and this is where extensions are added in the browser. So they just put a little icon here, and this is the little icon for Cite This For Me. So let's say, for example, your students are researching the upcoming Olympics in Rio, and they would like to know the schedule or a bit about the Olympics. And they run across this website, which I got from a very, very fast Google search, and they found some information here that they would like to share, and they want to do their citation. All that they'd have to do is be on the page that they're using, click the Cite This For Me extension button, and it automatically creates a citation for them that they can then copy paste. And what I always try to tell the students that I work with is to use MLA format. So they'll just choose that. They will simply copy paste this and add it to their Google presentation slide or their Google Docs, whatever that you're having them work on. Just wanted to show this to you. It's a huge time saver and a great way to stay correct with our research techniques.